Yeah, so I keep seeing builders posting, does AI coding suck? And not gonna lie, it kind of just makes me want to toss that question right back out there. Like, are we just using these tools the wrong way? Is there something we're all missing? Or is it just the hype burning us out? I don't know, but here's the thing. I really think we need to start building our own workflows around the AI, not just at it, you know? That's the real conversation I want to have here. So, if you've got stories, if you've got battle scars, if you've figured out a way to make these tools actually help you ship, drop it in the comments. Let's just talk about it for real. Just real quick, so I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS trenches for 8 years now, started out freelancing, helping clients ship their ideas, learning the hard way what actually works and what just burns you out. But after WW25, I went all in on solo dev. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started building everything out in public, and lately, Crafters Lab is where I've been putting all my energy. It isn't just another tutorial site or Discord to scroll past. This is my real home base for solo devs who treat AI like a teammate, not just a vending machine. Every deep dive guide, app blueprint, design workflow, even the exact Notion team spaces I use daily. They're all live here. It's all finally in one place on a private indie first platform. If you want real systems, real code, and a real community for solo devs, not just another AI clone farm, that's what I'm building. And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterslab.dev. All right, let's start where most of us actually live. Frustration. My days are split between deep, swift work in Xcode, quick prototyping in Cursor, and a running conversation with Claude or ChatGPT. And I'll be real, some days it feels like the only thing I'm doing is arguing with the model. You ask it to fix a bug, it rewrites the whole file. Misses your architecture or just gets weird. You tell yourself it's a skill issue, just prompt better. But even when you do everything right, there's no guarantee you'll get the same answer twice. What used to make coding satisfying, those tiny yes moments when you finally crack a problem, get replaced with this weird sense of disconnection. Like you get the right output, but you didn't really solve it. You just guided the AI, and now you're not even sure if it's your win or the model's. If it goes wrong, you just feel more stuck, or you lose half an hour untangling what it did. The predictability, the logical flow, it's all a little out of reach. And that's brutal for solo devs, because the thing about being indie is you depend on momentum. You need that sense that every session moves you forward, or at least doesn't set you back. But when you're bouncing between agentic tools that change every week, or you're watching the same prompt work one day and flop the next, it's easy to just burn out. I know that's where a lot of these AI coding sucks rants come from. I get it. But here's the twist. This unpredictability, the magic box feeling, that's not a bug. That's how these models work. They're not compilers, they're not logic engines. And no matter how many rules .md files you write, you're still working with a tool that might decide to riff on your idea instead of just executing it. So yeah, sometimes it does suck, but not because the model is broken. It's because we keep trying to use it like a vending machine and then getting mad when it doesn't spit out exactly what we ordered. Okay, so what's the move? For me, it was admitting that AI isn't going to just work. You have to meet it halfway. This is where my own rituals started to change. Instead of seeing Claude or Codex as this all-knowing oracle, I started treating it like a junior teammate. I'm talking real onboarding, not just here's my code, fix it, but here's how I think, here's how my app works, here's what I care about. This is what rules.md and claude.md are for, not homework, not busy work. They're onboarding for your AI sidekick, and honestly, for yourself a month from now. I drop every weird Swift UI pattern, every preferred script, all my indie quirks, right in those docs. Every project gets one, and if something's off in the workflow, I fix the doc first. But here's the next step that changed everything for me. MCPs, my Swift Brain database in Notion, isn't just for showing off. The same thing goes for agent SDKs, Claude's agent SDK, OpenAI's agent kit, whatever comes next. I'm not just using what the vendors ship, I'm building my own layer on top. I craft my own workflows with my own context, my own rituals. I know it sounds extra, but here's the honest truth. If you don't do this, you end up feeling like every new tool is just another wave you have to surf instead of a foundation you can actually build on. If you want to get real work done with AI, especially solo, you have to take ownership, treat every tool as raw material, not the final answer. So yeah, let's just call it, most new AI coding rants online are really just about workflow breakdowns. The solo devs who keep their heads above water aren't the ones chasing every new models or agent drop. They're the ones who built a rhythm around their stack, their context, and honestly, just keep refining their process, not their prompt. For me, that means having a clear explore, plan, code, commit loop every time. I don't just tell Claude to code. I ask it to read, then plan, then code. Always in phases, always with approvals in between. Sometimes I'll use sub-agents for different parts of a refactor. Sometimes I'll even run two Claude sessions side by side, one for code, one for review. I write tests before I write features. And when I feel that drift, when Claude starts going off the rails or the context window gets noisy, I clear, I reset, I recenter the session around what actually matters. That's the real lesson here. You can't rely on anyone else's workflow, not even mine. You have to build rituals that actually work for your projects, your brain, your stack, Claude Code, Codex, Cursor, whatever agent comes next. They're just tools. The minute you build your own rituals, your own rules, your own Swift brain, suddenly AI stops feeling like a slot machine and starts feeling like a real teammate, one that gets a little better every week. And if you're lucky, even make solo dev feel a little less lonely. Oh yeah, so here's the thing, right? Quick side quest for anyone curious about what's actually inside my Swift Brain Notion database. This is not some random list. It's like the living library of every course, book, deep dive, and all those pricey resources that you'd never find in a public repo or honestly, even in an AI's training data. I mean, we're talking courses that cost more than $100 a pop, those legendary Swift UI masterclasses, the really solid books, and the weird little events or private notes you'd otherwise never get access to. All the real indie dev gold that sits behind paywalls, it's in there. So, yeah, if you're a crafter over on crafterslab.dev, just jump in. Request access to the Notion team space, and you can literally duplicate the whole thing, remix it, tag it, add your own workflow hacks, or even use it as your own base for training up agent prompts or fine-tuning your own custom model. I don't know, experiment, break stuff, build your own indie command center. That's kind of the point. You want to keep a running log of agent rituals that don't suck? Go for it. You want to start building your own solo AI stack, starting from real battle-tested resources? It's yours. And here's the deal. Everything solid that I end up building or refining with the Swift Brain database, I'm going to share back to all crafters in the lab. I mean, come on. What's the point of locking this stuff away? And hey, who knows? Maybe we'll spin up a legit Swift crafter model at some point. But yeah, more on that in another video. Yeah, okay, so if you made it this far, seriously, thank you. I don't know, maybe you're nodding along, maybe you're yelling at your screen, or maybe you've got your own AI coding sucks story to drop in the comments. But honestly, that's kind of the whole point. We're all out here in the indie trenches, making it up as we go, tweaking our rituals, throwing stuff at the wall, seeing what sticks. And sometimes it works. Sometimes it absolutely does not. But if you take anything away from this, it's that you don't have to just live with the defaults. You can build your own way of working, layer in the tools you like, scrap the ones you don't, and just keep remixing until it actually feels like your workflow. I mean, that's what I'm trying to do with Crafters Lab. It's my indie little clubhouse where I drop my playbooks, my Swift brain, all my weird workflows, Notion templates, the stuff that actually saved me on real projects. If you're curious or you want a little extra help, check out crafterslab.dev. You can duplicate the stuff I use or just steal what works for you. Totally up to you. And, you know, if you've got your own hacks, your own don't ever do this stories, or just a trick that helped you survive another week in the solo dev wild, drop it below. I read every comment. I try to reply to everyone. And honestly, that's where half my best ideas come from anyway. So yeah, keep building, keep messing around, and not gonna lie, don't let the hype get to you. The real magic is in the workflow you build for yourself. And for what it's worth, solo doesn't have to mean alone. I'll see you next time. Peace.